Hey guys, it's Friday, and it is a dip day, so we got a break from the get-ups. I'm doing 4 days on, 1 day off, so I start back tomorrow. I'm enjoying them. However, I am getting a bit of upper back inflammation because I'm going heavier sooner. Going up 5 and 5 isn't a whole lot of volume, and that's why we do it every day. However, because I'm very familiar with get-ups, I did them literally all through my, I started doing them back in 2004 when I first learned them, but they were a staple. This program, Simple and Sinister, a staple during my ultra running because I could have a viable strength routine without taking up a lot of time. I could do it daily and it didn't interfere with my running. So I was able to jump up and wait a little bit faster. Plus, you know, burpees definitely keep you strong. Doesn't necessarily mean I should have made that jump up. So a little bit of upper back inflammation, switching spots. My lower back is starting to feel better, which is good. However, a day off, you know, today. We're gonna get some dips, we're gonna get some burpees. I'm gonna do 2 sets of dips like I've been doing. And then, excuse me guys, wait a set of dips. And then probably Paul from Oregon's Imam workout for whatever time I have left after 22 minutes. Relatively easy session, I hope. Let's get started. 10 second count there. See how this feels on the upper back. Seven reps down, 12 reps to my best, recent best. It's feeling pretty good. But I was feeling it in my upper back. Eating something, guys. So, discretion, what is that old saying? Better part of valor? Something like that. It's been a whole week since I've done them, so there's that too. That's okay. An off day. But an off day with 15 reps. Or, I'm sorry, 18 reps. Thank you. We got 7 reps last night. The goal is when I make it to 10, I move up to 1. One thing, my shoulders definitely fatigue pretty quick on my first set of dips due to the entire week of get-ups. Fatigue, they didn't hurt, they weren't sore. The shoulders are actually feeling pretty decent lately with the get-ups and the reduction of horizontal pressing. If the EMOM workout can chase the inflammation in the upper back away. The dips didn't do it. Some seconds, guys, I'm going to dive right in. Thank you.
Tough finish.
Finish off with some push downs, guys. Two sets. Just gonna stretch out that upper back. Sorry guys, 20 reps. So I might have a touch of the flu. I think I mentioned that. Hoping to sweat it out. That might be also what's causing the back inflammation. That and the heavier get-ups. Last set. Done, guys. Yep, I'm making weird noises. Alright, guys. I was reading a bit this morning from concepts of, not really concepts, thoughts, from Jay Krishnamurti. If you're not familiar with Krishnamurti, both UJ Krishnamurti and Jay Krishnamurti. Differences in their realizations or how they vocalize it, but both are very, very valuable. This morning it was more along the lines of Jay Krishnamurti. It's a bit more clinical, for lack of a better word. But I do enjoy his writings and I've had his books for decades, since I was a kid. He talked about what I was reading this morning, or childhood innocence and curiosity. Now, that was the way we learned everything, through curiosity. We saw someone, no one taught us how to walk. No one demonstrated and said, this is walking, and this is how you do it, this is how you hold your hands, this is where you put your head up, walk like me. We watched, and we tried, and we failed, and eventually we learned. Somewhere, that was replaced with hands-on teaching by other people, teachers, parents, friends, neighbors, and we lost our innocent learning, our learning by curiosity. Not completely, but it's hidden. I think when you get older, it's the perfect time to invoke its presence again. Start learning through the natural curiosity of trying. Trying might be taking lessons in something. It might be watching a video or asking questions, or it might be just picking something up and giving it a shot completely on its own. It might be following your intuition. It doesn't matter. As long as you are following that curiosity, that spontaneous urge to try something, you're returning to that childhood innocence that is our ever-present reality. We just don't know it any longer. This is what Buckminster Fuller said when he said, dare to be naive. People are going to tell you all kinds of stuff, what you can do, what you can't do, what's possible, what's impossible. We live in a world filled with starving children, starving families, crime, warfare, division, hatred, warring political parties, all over, honestly, an imaginary line. It doesn't truly exist except as a thought. Everything, every single war started with a thought. Emerson said, the ancestor to every action is a thought. Imagine if we didn't have that thought of, this is mine and I'm going to take it back. It doesn't mean that we don't have borders and nations. It doesn't mean that we don't do our best to maintain those borders with a sense of both a sense of welcome and also a sense of protection, protecting those who are innocent on both sides. However, these are all things that we've learned. Imagine if we did what Buckminster Fuller said, who was a genius, by the way, and dared to be naive, that things could be different. I've been thinking of and repeating a teaching that I learned through my study in A Course in Miracles. When people ask, why does God allow starving children? That's a legitimate question, but here's the answer. God doesn't allow starving children. We do, every day, collectively making a decision, unconsciously. We don't go to bed and say, well, one more day with starving children. But we don't wake up in the morning and say, this day, we're not going to have it happen, because we have the resources, we have the logistics to make it happen. From the top down, we have it. Why we don't do it? I don't know, guys. But we could. Dare to be naive. As well, don't accept invitations for other people to close off your world in any way. And they will offer it in all of its well-intentioned. That's the thought process. It doesn't have to be yours, though. So, with that, I'll see you guys later.